gentlemen. I said I was going to stop saying ladies and gentlemen.
Already. Back to it.
I'm old school. I'm a yes. Zennial.
Yes.
I'm a Zennial. I'm a Zennial.
You're accepting that. Are you going with that? Tell me right now. Are you going with that?
Yes. I'm a Zennial.
Okay. I'm not going with it.
You're not going with it?
Nope.
So what are you?
I'm Generation X.
No, we're not.
No?
We're not. I told you this before. We're Generation Y.
Okay.
They skipped over us.
Right.
They skipped over us. Because we're not X. X was a whole nother group of people.
Oh, no, you're right. So we're Y.
We're
Y. I'll accept Y, but I won't accept
you want anything,
any form of any.
I think that is such a... Who cares? I am the revolution. You are now locked into the best, the number one rated Mr. Robot pregame show, not after show, pregame show on the interweb social medias.
Yes.
Yes. I am the revolution. And this is
Jayco. Jayco.
Of
SCN.
I was going to say of Jayco is it.
Of
I don't
Jayco
know.
Jayco is it. You can follow me at Jayco is it.
You can follow him at Jayco is it. Who is this? Oh, okay. That was you. You were retweeting.
I was.
I heard buzzes off the set.
I thought I was getting texts.
You weren't getting texts. You weren't getting texts. Oh, no, Jayco, he wasn't getting texts, nope. But Ravo's getting sex. Yes, Ravo's getting sex. I bet you God almighty that Ravo is getting sex. Did you just go into mammy hands? Did you just mammy hands me?
That wasn't a mammy hand.
Well, which hands is it, damn it? Which hands did you just give
that
me?
That was a presentation, yeah.
And yeah.
Spirit fingers.
No, no, no.
I wasn't doing
those jazz
yeah.
hands. You were, yeah.
The top of your brain.
Mammy, 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 mammy.
Well, you know, I am
yep.
related. So.
Yep.
Can't, yep. I can't deny that one.
I can't deny it. You don't want to. Got the. And why am I bleeping out all the regular words? That's so weird.
It
I'm a
weird.
Strange...
Man, what's folks is just buzzy buzzing.
What's all this media coordinator?
It's a popping.
It's a...
Hot grits a popping.
Hot grits a flying. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get into some Mr. Robot,
let's
shall we?
That's what
and let's
for.
Get us into a little bit of RAM. Ladies and gentlemen, RAM is Random Access Memories. That is where we recap last week's episode to talk about and catch you up with what happened last week before we zip into this week. Because guess what, ladies and gentlemen? Here on the Mr. Robot pregame show, we must go back to the past before we go back to the future. You see what I did there?
Yes.
You see what I did there?
Very good, sir.
Yeah, I thought I should...
No,
bash
you
the thing
mm-hmm.
over the
yes psh, 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 boom psh, boom psh, boom
psh, psh. No mine was psh, psh,
psh, psh. Good clubbing.
Okay, so last week I got my notes here. Let's see, we open up immediately to Elliot. Child Elliot
mm-hmm.
and his father. Do we mm-hmm. know his name? I always call him Quincy.
Yes, we do know his name. I just don't remember it.
I call him Quincy. Don't roll
Quincy
over there.
Quincy Alderson.
Quincy Alderson. His name
We're
is Quincy.
We're going with that now.
It's Quincy.
Quincy begat Elliot.
Yep.
And Elliot begat 5'9". Right?
5'9".
Isn't that the attack? That's the day of the attack? That's what they call it. 5'9".
So that's his baby? His
That's
baby
his
is five
baby.
Now?
Yeah.
No, that was Mr. Robot's baby. That wasn't Elliot's baby. Okay. So, speaking of Mr. Robot, right? So, his daddy is showing him how to eat popcorn and they go into their little movie night.
Mm-hmm.
And Elliot seemed to have been a little a-hole since he was a little kid.
Yes.
But was he acting out of anger and depression? Or was this who Elliot was? I can't tell.
Okay. So, I think it was out of anger and depression because this scene... like opened up the Mr. Robot world for me. Just that
Ooh,
little scene.
Did it?
Yes.
Talk to me.
All of the memories that we've had so far of Elliot, even though he told the story of the pushing out of the window.
Yeah, it was wrong.
All those other memories and him talking with Darlene and everything, I always thought he loved his dad. I always thought he was like looked up to his dad, and that's why he put him in this, you know, alternate ego role, right? Mm-hmm. But I think he hated his dad.
Mm. Oh, spit.
And Mr. Robot is who he wanted
his dad to be. Damn, son. I need to be that meme right now, like, oh. Damn. Turn me into a GIF. I'm trying to be turned into a GIF.
Plenty of opportunities. Plenty of opportunities. But don't be ripping our videos.
But you have to turn me into a GIF. I'm going to go back for him. Is my face animated enough for a GIF? Damn. Okay. So, y'all mamas. So, Mr. Robot, okay, but here's the thing that got me, though. Mm-hmm. He immediately got very comfortable talking to his imaginary friend.
Yeah, that right there, it started.
No, it didn't. Nope. 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 Nope.
It had already begun.
I don't know how long it's been there,
yeah.
But he was familiar talking to him. He didn't just snap into this, no.
He was waiting for that coach.
He was comfortable. Nah, I think that this nigga been crazy the whole time. I think he might have been crazy the whole time.
Speaking of that word.
Time?
The N word. Can we just address the fact that little Elliot was a white kid?
Yeah, like.
and Big Elliot is not.
Like, come on, fam. You are very, you're lightly melanated. Like. I see it there, fam. You not DeBarge melanated. You right past DeBarge melanated.
Yeah.
You like Jet melanated.
Yes. So, I don't know what that choice was.
Do y'all know
was,
who Jet is?
That casting choice.
Sing a Jet record right now. What's a big record?
On the spot, I can't come up with it.
Shut your ass up and hit them damn switches, punk. What is all that? Ka-ka. Enti, who? So you said, Elliot is slightly Negroidian, and
that boy was white.
Now
he's
Caucasoidian.
Mm-hmm.
Uh huh. Okay.
But anyway,
so first of all, let me say this: I love that episode. Mm-hmm. It was probably one of my favorite episodes of not just this season, but of the whole series.
Yes.
Like one of my favorite episodes of the entire series. This was a great episode. And what was the little boy name? What was his name?
Trenton's brother.
Yeah, Trenton's brother.
I don't know.
What was the little?
You got it written down in your notes.
It's probably somewhere. Mobley's brother, but I just got Mobley's brother. It
wasn't Mobley's brother?
Huh?
It wasn't Mobley's brother.
It was Trenton's brother.
Yeah.
Man, I'm gonna try to tell y'all
which
right
we
now.
We found
man.
Out. That's where she got her nickname because they were from Trenton.
They were from Trenton. And you know who else is from Trenton?
Gay.
Huh?
Gay.
Gay?
Gay. Like, who?
What? What is happening right now?
Yeah. Gay.
Are you doing French right now?
That's Spanish. Actually, it's what? That's not who. Gay is what?
Yes. Like, I'm not following you, son.
Who else is from Trenton?
Man, you messing up the whole steez right now, baby. I hate this show. I hate it.
We go from the number one top rated to hate.
No, but it still is the top rated pregame.
That's true.
Mr. Robot pregame show.
That's true. That is true.
Yes, it's the only.
Quality, quantity, whatever. Well,
spickety, speckety, spoop. My nigga Big Ben Samedi is from Trenton, New Jersey. That's who. Shout out to my LB. Woo! Black Angels, baby.
I'll drink to that.
Yeah. Big Ben Samedi from Trenton, New Jersey.
So.
Yep.
It was a great episode.
It was a remarkable episode. What was some highlights in it before we get to the part that I really, really, really came to talk about?
it was so human.
Yes, very human. I said that when he was on the beach and he was trying to get rid of him, It was Elliot was like almost in tears. Like he was.
I wrote a note when I was watching. I said That was the most real life scenario Elliot's been in the whole show.
Yeah.
And it was so real because I've been around little kids. I have a little kid. And that little boy was annoying. He was little kid annoying.
He was annoying, but I think he was engaging him at every step. And what's funny is that, let me say this. I think they did a masterful job in showing a believer of Islam saved his life. That he came in with nothing but love and compassion.
Bro.
He wanted to go to his church. He wanted to go. Well, it's a mosque. All praises due. Egg, leg, arm, head. Yes. Allah. So.
Did he know?
Did who know?
Did the boy know?
Nah, he didn't know. It was so innocent.
Yeah.
He was literally following his spirit. His spirit told him to go do. I believe that because he was so angelic. I felt like he was being guided by a divine power.
Absolutely.
At that moment.
Like that. And I want to clarify that I liked the kid's character.
Oh, I love his acting.
When he was an annoying kid, he was good at it.
Yeah, he was perfect. No, you don't have to. F them out there who thinks that you... I come down to the kid. We'll come down. Man, hey, forget. Man, that little. Hey, he was wet, kid.
We could roll that clip. Don't talk.
Don't talk. Just
stay there. Don't talk.
Don't talk. Don't talk.
Y'all see it. It's an inside joke, but not for long.
Not for long. Y'all see it. and it was just remarkable. That directing was beautiful. All the acting. One of my favorite scenes is like, can you do it? He's like, yes.
Yeah.
Exactly. It was like, he was so annoyed, but he was going tit for tat with this.
That was like my favorite.
Junior high kid. Yeah. Like this kid, maybe we had to be in the sixth grade at best.
I can do it.
It was
hilarious.
Now, let's move on.
Okay.
You know what? We're going to take a quick break because I want y'all to see the commercial. That's the only reason why, because we normally go right through.
Right.
So roll the commercial and then come back to us, ladies and gentlemen. We the Robot.
The weather outside is frightful, and the fire is so delightful, and... Oh, hello. I'm Chesney with the Fifth Column Network. You just caught me engaging in one of my favorite pastimes at Christmas, singing and playing the piano. You know what one of my other favorite pastimes is? FCN's 12 Days of Christmas list. Join us every day at 7 p.m. on the Fifth Column Network, beginning December the 12th. You're not going to want to miss this.
Twas the night before the first day of Christmas. Oh, no, wait. Who wants that old story? Not us. We want debates and hot takes. See what FCN says is the best of Christmas. 12 Days of Christmas List. December 12th through the 23rd, nightly at 7 p.m. Only on the Fifth Column Network.
Welcome back to We the Robot here on FCN. Live streaming simulcast here on Periscope, YouTube, and definitely Facebook with... We're definitely Facebook. YouTube is out here giving us the old heave-ho and the old butthole.
Yes, they are.
And Rob, I see you watching. Don't worry about how I paid those kids. Those kids were for scale. And if you tell their agents, I will hunt your 6'5" ass down. And
I commented, Rob, I'll let you know. I said they got paid not a butt whooping.
They got paid not a butt whooping. Okay. So let's get on with it, man. The one thing that bothered me was the heavy-handed time travel gimmick.
They laid it on thick.
So let's talk about the first and foremost one. they go to the movies, and the film there is Back to the Future.
Right.
And everybody's dressed up, and we're like, oh, okay.
Right, because it's on the day of Back to the Future 2, the day that they actually traveled in that movie.
In that film.
It's the real day. And he's like, oh, I always wanted to be here on this day. I didn't even know it was happening, and here I am.
And here, in time, in real time. Mm-hmm. This he's being swept away and it was dope because he's you know, he said, did you like movies? Mm-hmm. So I used to love them a lot, right. You know, so it was a lot that connected his past.
Yeah.
But the time travel thing kind of jerked me a little.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on this? Because you are the one that first told me about the time travel story.
Well,
potential theory.
I think you actually mentioned this part. Like, I think he's throwing everything at us to throw us off what's actually going to happen.
Yeah.
So I don't think time travel is going to actually happen on this show.
Okay.
I'm thinking he's not going that way. And it's there at this point, they're just going in on it.
They're just going in. Okay. Did you catch the ending when he and Bug-Eyed McSue was sitting back to back on the door? Did you catch
that reference? I caught it the second time around.
Yeah, you caught it the second time.
Help.
Who was a little help
from Ravo?
Oh, okay. Because it just kind of sounded like you were kind of getting ready to lean away from my contributions.
Absolutely, I was. So okay. I was going to get away with as much as you let me get away with,
and I wasn't.
Not a thing.
No.
So yeah, I figured it out after you told me the exact thing that it was.
Got you. So, well done, by the way. I wonder how many of you out there caught the song when they were hanging out talking about their childhood. And I was sitting watching it last week, and I said, man, that song is awfully familiar. Mm-hmm. And the first thing that came to my head was John Hughes films.
Yeah, and that's what I thought at first.
Yeah, too. And I was like, no, that's not a John Hughes movie, because I literally ran through all of them. And I was like, no, please, no, that's not it. And I was like, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. And then once the song started singing, I said, God dang it. Mm-hmm. It is Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Like, which is a film about time travel.
Yep.
So let me ask you this. How upset would you be for him to have jerked you around? Which one would upset you more? Mm-hmm. Him actually having time travel as the plot device or doing all of this and not doing time travel?
That be the actual plot device. I think actual time travel would piss me off.
Yeah.
Because I don't feel like my chain's been jerked. I feel like he's been doing some really good, you know, hints. Not subtle hints, but hints about the time travel. But they can go. And I believe that the way he writes, the way Sam Esmail writes, that he can tie it in and it not be a reach. Mm. So I don't think I'll be mad. Ah! Not live.
My phone just dropped. Oh. What time is it?
9:49.
9:49. Okay. So you wouldn't be too upset. Okay. Yeah. Let's.
How about you?
I'm on the fence. I don't really know yet.
Okay.
What's the next segment?
Zero node.
Zero node.
Zero Note!
So, Zero Note is the part of the show that we talk about our predictions, right?
Predictions. What's going to happen tonight?
What is going to happen the episode before last? What is going to happen? What do you think is going to happen?
I just played all the instruments.
You just played them?
So, I think this is going to be good because, number one, we're about to see Ellie with a purpose again. He hasn't had a purpose in a while. He's kind of been like, oh, what's going on? What have I done? I want to do this, but I want to do this.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you know, the whole redirecting the paper was a purpose, but it wasn't an Elliot purpose. It was him kind of being reactionary and trying to stop.
Yeah.
I think we're seeing Ellie with a purpose. That email from Trenton at the end.
Yes.
He's like, oh, there's something I can do.
Yeah.
And this is that moment he needed to snap back into Elliot.
Snap back to reality. Up, there goes Elliot. Up, there goes.
And he's got a sweater. Sweater on his keyboard already. Mom's spaghetti.
Dead mom spaghetti.
Mom is alive.
Mom's alive?
Yeah, remember she's in the home. Like she's in the crazy
home.
Oh,
yeah, she's in the crazy home. Just why is she crazy?
Vegged out. I don't explain that either.
I don't know. So predictions. I think we go back to Agent Rub One Out.
Yep.
And blah, blah, blah.
Alexa, how do I masturbate?
Do you like to go spelunking or just a little bit of both, Alexa? Might you try the stinger?
This is why we the greatest. Okay.
Alexa, how do you keep me from getting dragged on the social webs?
Proceed now to delete each and every account that you own. That is all. Oh, boy.
Would you say, Alexa?
Rob wants to know how much time is left.
Shut up, Rob. Shut up. Rob, listen, stop playing with us, okay? We do this show how we want to do this show. If we want to just slap ass and act like a couple of, what'd he say? Alexa, delete your account. Shut your ass up, Rob. Okay, I think we get away from Elliot. I think we get to White Rose. Mm-hmm.
So,
and Agent Dom, like she's putting some stuff together.
Yes.
And I think she has a purpose and I think Elliot has a purpose. I think somewhere their worlds converge.
Well, I don't know if you watched the preview, but
no, I stay away from previews.
He got to I can't never remember his name, the guy with the New York accent with the glasses that's the hitman and also the car mechanic.
Oh, Jui McJuju.
Yeah. He's like, take me to White Rose. He gets in the car with him, like, take me to White Rose. So he wants to talk to White Rose. He's ready to make a move.
See?
My bold prediction, even though we heard him
spicy
in that preview, you know, sometimes they play clips from future happenings.
Yeah, don't say future.
No, well, you heard Mr. Robot in there, but I don't think he's making an appearance this episode. We're not. He's right
it's
now.
Elliot.
It's not him. It's Elliot.
It's Elliot.
Yep.
Okay. So, what time is it? 9:54.
You never talked about
what
why you loved this episode. We didn't touch that particular point. You said we was gonna come back to it.
Oh. Let's get into a little fatal.
What? Internal fatal error.
Internal fatal.
Okay.
You know the segment. Hit it.
And we're back.
Are we?
Yeah. That's delayed.
Oh, what we got?
It was in reference to y'all masturbation.
Yeah.
Show some skin from a Mr. Blake Shelton. Oh, Blake Surface, my bad.
Blake. This one goes out to you, Blakey. Blake wants some skin. You gets it all, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been We, the Robot on FCN. I'm going to dance you all out to a little bit of skinnery.
Ladies and gentlemen, full panel.
Oh my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, for Revolution, this is J. Cole saying, watch We the Robot next week. It will be the season finale. Tonight you can just watch the regular robot show on USA. Tomorrow we coming back with Prime News at 7 p.m.-ish, depending on how quickly Miss Trezeney is ready. And next week we start our 12 Days of Christmas list. Tuesday the 12th, 7 p.m. daily. 12 days. We count down the best of all of your Christmas favorites. These lists are hashtag facts. You'll love them. You can't get enough of them. They are hot and sticky sweet lists from their head to their feet. That is all.